Hey there, you just scanned the QR code for this book, meaning you want to read it, but you're not sure if it's going to be good, right? I think, however, that you'll love this book. I've been told on many occasions that I'm a hard person to please when it comes to books. I need a really good one, or I won't read it at all. Well, this one has definitely exceeded my expectations. Don't believe me? Just take a look at this quote. Because we weren't like other people, we were peculiar. Peculiar how? Oh, all sorts of ways, he said. Whoa, right? I mean, look at how captivating it already is. Who is he? Who were we? What does it mean to be peculiar? Unfortunately, I can't answer these for you, but the book can. This quote basically captures the essence of the book, and if it's already this interesting, the book will definitely be interesting as well. What's this book about, you ask? Well, this book is a first-person story, which revolves around Jacob. Jacob was told about monsters as a kid. He loved listening to his grandfather's wild stories at night. His grandfather talked about a girl that could manipulate fire, another that could fly, and siblings that could throw boulders the size of houses. He talked about the bird that helped him find safety, and the building that kept him away from the war. After a while, Jacob stopped believing. They were just far-fetched stories that were told him because he wanted to quench Jacob's thirst for the unreal. They had to be fake! Until one day, his grandfather was inexplicably murdered. The theory was that it was a pack of dogs, but Jacob swore he saw something in the woods. A monster. I bet you want to open the book up and start reading already. If you do, great, go ahead. If not, keep watching. You'll definitely change your mind. Now, a big question when it comes to choosing a good book is, what is the theme? What are the morals behind this book? I found the message of the book as trust, to trust others and yourself. Why do I say this? Well, Jacob had to trust his grandfather was telling the truth about these monsters. He didn't, and there were dire consequences. He had to trust himself. He had to believe that he had the ability to fight off these monsters. And he had to trust Miss Peregrine to place his safety in her care. He had to. But did he? Read the book to find out. And finally, have you ever read a book with vintage photographs so real they make you wonder if the book is really fictitious? A story that is mysterious yet interesting, where every piece of information you receive always contradicts what you think the answer is? If you haven't, then try this one. Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children is so eerie that it may just send chills up your spine, yet so indulging you won't be able to put the book down until the very end. Can't choose between realistic fiction and fantasy? Well, here's your answer. This book is both filled with characters so real you'll relate to them on a personal level, and stories so wild your imagination won't be able to comprehend them. So if you're into mystery novels, realistic and fantasy books, as well as dark fiction, this book is definitely for you. So what are you waiting for? Open the book and start reading!